Welcome friends, in this video let's discuss about Shishunaga dynasty, which is a continuation of Hiranyaka dynasty of Mauryan empire. Okay, Shishunaga was the founder of this dynasty and he was the governor of last Hiranyaka ruler Naga Dashaka. Okay, so after coup d'etat, the Shishunaga made Rajgriha as his residence and he deputed his son to Banaras. So he was succeeded by his son Kalakosha. Okay, so during Kalakosha, Pataliputra became the capital of Magadha. So the Kalakosha conducted second Buddhist council, okay, Kalakosha of Shishunaga dynasty. Okay, Kalakosha conducted second Buddhist council and at Varanasi in 383 BC. So in this council the main dispute was on 10 points related to the rules to be followed in Sangha. So this dispute was not settled and the Buddhism sect appeared for the first time in history, Buddhist history. So the president of this council was Sabhakami and the last ruler of Shishunaga dynasty were 10 sons of Kalakosha. This is oligarchy, who ruled simultaneously. Out of them, one son, Nandi Vardhana, was mentioned in the Puranas as well. So this Shishunaga dynasty were succeeded by Nanda dynasty. So Mahapadmananda was the first ruler of Nanda dynasty. So he was son of a barber. So this started the trend of low born rule in Magadhan empire. So these Nandas were the first non-Kshatriya rulers in the history of India. So they were also the first empire builders because they expanded their territory to length and breadth of the country. So Nanda ruled almost all part of the India for 100 years. So last ruler of Nanda was Dhanananda. So he was defeated. He was defeated by Chandragupta Maurya, that's founding Mauryan Empire in 321 BC. Okay, so there were a lot of reasons for the success of Magadhan Empire. So these reasons were very important. So this is a direct mains question. So please be careful and watch this. So in mains, question may arise like this: what were the causes for the success of Magadhan Empire? So this is the direct answer for this. So let's look at this. So Magadhan Empire was succeeded because some of the ambitious rulers. So formation of the largest state in India during this period was due to the ambitious rulers like Bimbisara, Ajatashatru, Mahapadmananda of Magadhan Empire. So these rulers employed all means, that is fair and foul means, to enlarge the territory and to strengthen their states. Okay, for example, Bimbisara employed matrimonial alliance with other kingdoms to expand his territory and to create alliances in the statecraft. Okay, so other fair and foul means were also employed to expand their territories at the cost of other Mahajanapadas during 6th to 4th century BC. Okay, so they enjoyed an advantageous geographical position in the age of iron because the territory of Magadhan Empire was richest in iron. Okay, this iron was used for designing the efficient war machineries and war equipments, and also these were used for agriculture implements, which helped to produce surplus food, which also diverted to military and also administration. So this provided surplus food and growth of cities during this period. So this helped the expansion of the Magadhan Empire. So the capital of Magadhan Empire, that is Rajgriha and Pataliputra, was situated at very strategic positions. Okay, Rajgriha was surrounded by 5 hills. Okay, and it was inaccessible at that period because of the situation. Okay, the Pataliputra, apart from that, occupied a pivotal position commanding communication on all the sides. So it was situated on the confluence of Ganga, okay, Ganga, Gandak and Kosi. So excuse me. So in those days communication were difficult. So army could move north, west, south and east by following course of the river. So army could be mobilized in every direction during that period using the course of the river. So this helped in facing the enemy threats and also to attack the enemy at whatever time they want. So this provided strategic position and also strategic advantage to the Magadhan kings to use their army and also military at the best possible way. Okay, so it was surrounded by all the sides from the rivers, the Pataliputra. So it is also considered as Jaladurga. So it was inaccessible at that time given the technology. So Next is the productive lands of the middle Gangetic plain produced varieties of paddy because it helped in producing considerable surplus, which was taxed by the rulers, and surplus food was used for military organization and also for administration, which provided the prosperity and helped in expansion of the empire. So Magadhan first used elephants on large scale in the warcraft against neighbors, so this provided them the strategic advantage. So these are the things which were helpful in expanding Magadhan empire. Thanks for watching. Please share this videos, please like this video, and subscribe to this channel if you are not subscribed. And there's a good news for beginners and working professionals, because I have started a new initiative called Weekly Current Affairs Analysis Initiative, which provides you the integrated approach for both prelims and mains examination from current affairs point of view. So I'm giving the background information about all the current affairs topics and provides insights into how this can be used in prelims and mains examination in this initiative. So every week more than 40 videos will be uploaded related to current affairs, and detailed analysis will be made for these topics. So this will provide you very good approach for the examination. If you want, you can subscribe to this initiative. Click here and subscribe to this initiative. You will never be disappointed, because I am getting very good reviews from my subscribers at present. If you join, you can also benefit from this initiative. Please join if you are interested. It is very affordable. Okay, thanks for watching.